Hello everyone, and welcome to SOMA, the next, hopefully masterpiece, I hope, from Fictional Games. I was a huge fan of Amnesia when it came out at the time, and I've been looking forward to SOMA since, I think about since it was first announced, really. So I'm really excited to get through this. I did start up a game already just to test the recording this thing in 1440p and all that. But first of all, like I did with Darkwood, and I think this time I will put a little note here to skip this, but I'm going to go ahead and look at some of the menus to show y'all what options we have. Ah, there we go. Now it's all color balanced. Yeah, so we have lots and lots of language options, which is good. I don't know what this does. I haven't looked at it yet. I'm assuming these are all just kind of basic effects, controls, lots of key bindings as usual. Rotate. Oh, middle mouse, that's right. I should probably. Let's make middle mouse. Not left mouse. That's not what I did. Okay. That's alarming. That's not good. Flashlight. I'm gonna move that to there. Does it? I guess that it's defaulting. It's defaulting. No. Go down. No. Just always thinks that middle mouse is actually that. So all right, I'm gonna. Let's not do that. Okay, that's cool. We have that on video now. Excellent. I'm gonna go ahead and bind that there. I'm gonna keep F just in case. I'm not gonna rebind inventory because I don't know if I'll need that yet. Yes. I'm not using a controller, so I don't care about that. Video! So I guess this tries to max out the video settings. This all looks. Let's not play with that too much. I don't know if I should keep. I probably. Adaptive. What does that mean? I don't want to play with it and keep it on. That might be some kind of horrible. I maxed this out earlier too, and our AI options are just this. Sure, I don't really change anything. Post effect, SSO and bloom, on or off, depth of field, variety of options there. Seems like it keeps changing. Oh, I get it. Yeah, so. Okay. Yep. And low, medium, and high. Good. Shadow call. Ooh, there's a very high. Interesting. Oh, let's try that. I want to see what that looks like. Yes, why not? It's probably a bad idea. I'll probably have to turn that off. But whatever. The camera looks great to me. I don't know how it's going to affect the video on your end, because the monitor's kind of calibrated for. Do I want subtitles? I guess I do. Just because I'm going to be talking over it. Not necessarily closed caption, because that's going to add text for all the things. Okay, so that's our options. I'm going to go ahead and start a new game, because I didn't actually get very far. I literally just got to the starting area and ran around and did some tests. So, yeah. That little icon is creepy as fuck. Reality is that which, when you stop believing in it, doesn't go away. That's.
Are you okay, Simon?
Interesting definition.
I think you're bleeding.
Oh, that's nothing. It's just my brain can't stop bleeding from the accident.
Here, take this.
No, that's for later, for the scan.
It's green.
Ashley, I need to tell you something.
I'm a robot.
Simon, please don't make this weird.
No, it's not like that. Why now?
Who's David Munchie?
Why is there never enough time?
For what?
Floating icon.
Christ.
Well, that was something. Ooh, trippy. Alright, that's my
favorite. I'm up.
Simon Jarrett?
Yeah, that's sure. Me.
My name is David Munchie. We spoke earlier.
The brain scan. I remember.
Are you all right?
Yeah, just a bad dream. Are we still on for today?
Yeah, that's why I'm calling. I wanted to remind you to drink the tracer fluid I sent you. It'll help me capture a better image of the damages.
Don't worry, I got it somewhere.
Okay, great. Well, I'll see you in a couple of hours then.
Okay, see you soon.
I really like this setup. It is the second time I said it, but I did want to comment on it. Even when I was initially here, holy crap, this frame rate, this feels lower than I remember it. Oh right, it doesn't, they have a weird rendering architecture. Those shadows are probably a little bit more than I want to handle. I really like that cutscene.
Where did I put the tracer fluid?
It's good, right, I need to pick up the tracer fluid, but this, and it's metal mouse? Okay, cool, that works. That's kind of awkward. Does I have to hold left click and middle mouse? R is a really good idea. Okay. Yeah. What is that noise?
Come on, radioactive tracer fluid, where are you?
Come on, Jesse, pick up meds. Flowers for funeral. Okay, so there's a funeral going on. Ah, okay. I right click to get out of that, and that was really natural. I have missed this in games, just the whole, here's the thing! I don't know why I can pick it up, but I can just interact with things. This is not a good, you would never want to interact with an actual vacuum cleaner like that.
Summer's coming. Hope it's a good one.
Grimoire. First interact with them and pull on the mouse. Yeah, no, I love that interaction scheme. Like, I just opened this by swiping my mouse left and right. Oh, my doors, that's right. Ah, oh, it's so beautiful. I love it. Sorry, I'm a little bit of a fanboy and I know it. That's cool. I like that effect. That's, yep, it's not very well kept, apparently. It feels like my mouse is a little weird, slow. No, it's fine. We're looking for tracer fluid. That's not super high quality, but it's pretty good. It's interactive. I have a light in my bathroom? Is that a thing? In like Europe or wherever it is that we are? I've never seen that before.
I don't want to keep the doctor waiting. I'll shower when I get back.
That's a good excuse for not having to do that. It's like, why would you do that? That's dumb. Hamper? Can I track this hamper at all? No. Just stand on it. Like a nerd. Okay. What's in here? Video games! This looks bad. Man. I mean, his head does bleed, so I guess it makes sense. That. No tracer fluid in there. Is that a lock? Can I lock it? Oh, that's like a little occupied symbol. That's cool. I haven't seen that in apartments before either. It's really nice. At least we have some light in here. I really like... Is that dynamic? Is that fully dynamic? No. Okay, so that's like a baked thing and they just turn it on and off. It's pretty cool though. It looks nice. Real time is always better, but ooh. So apparently he's very much into either anime or some kind of video game thing, or both. They're not exclusive. There's nothing down here. There's a lot of detail on this thing. I want to put this thing down gently. That's not really an option. Ooh, it makes sound. Interesting. Does it have stuff inside it? Cool. Well, soon, Glove Bomb. Sick little thing. Yes, I can read. What's that? No. What does that say at the bottom? So. Something, sick, treatment, love. Dr. Phil. I don't know what the first word is. I'm a little bit tired, so I can't really read it. Order. At 712 convention? So did he make that thing, or? I don't really know what's in here. It won't let me read it with left click either, so that's just gonna be a mystery, I guess. Ooh, I like that detail. There's a coffee stain under it. It's all this. Simon Jarrett. That's my Where is MS Toronto? Okay, so this is Canada. Dr. Aaron Peak. Base Lab, Toronto Signature. So this is like a prescription for something. Grimoire, meet and greet, book signing. Oh, I can also use WASD to and the mouse together. Oh, I love it. I love it when games do that. That was one of my favorite things about, well, not one of my favorite. It was a thing I really liked about Skyrim, where it was just like all of the input methods, like keyboard and mouse, worked together pretty well. I like, so this takes place contemporarily, 11 January 15. I like the beach, nothing up back. That's really reflective. Okay, so that's just a picture of his feet. That's presumably the girl from the thing, and we're really into Grimoire. This needs better light for me to look at it, but it's clearly a picture of the beach. What's the post? Kid. That made me really happy that I could do that. I can't read that post-it. This post-it? That post-it. What's in the drawers? Fuck you, vacuum cleaner. Okay, so tutorial on drawers. Okay, so these are the R is not. No, that's R, it's fine. So much detail. So I like photography enough to invest in those kinds of things, at least. That's like more than most people invest in their photography. Summer blockbusters. Japanimation bigger than ever. Stunts versus CGI. What's a bottle movie? That is an excellent question. What is a bottle movie? Massive Recoil 2, Flawless Execution. Theaters, December 13th. Oh, wait. Ah, there we go. The Ultimate Movie Bus. Okay, so it's just reading. Oh, so I should be doing that more, I guess. Is there more under it? Or can I do anything about that? No. Okay. No, I just want to interact with your drawer. It's here. That's not readable. This is. Downtown accident kills a young woman. Toronto. Yesterday, a driver distracted by her children ran a red light, causing her to blindside a car at the intersection of Bloor Street and Sapadina Road. I wonder if those are real places or if it's just made up places in Toronto. The mother and her children, traveling in a robust SUV, were left bruised but largely unharmed. The other party were less lucky. The car crashed into the passenger side. Ashley Hall, 23, sustained devastating damages and suffocated from blood trapped in her lungs before the ambulance arrived. That's really depressing. Her friend and driver, Simon Jarrett, 26, survived, but with complicated results to leave him permanent brain damage. Okay, so this is a memento from the crash that apparently killed our friend? Girlfriend? Or, no, friend. I guess I shouldn't try to read too much more into that than it says. The driver of TZ, whose name has not been released by police, presumably claims it was an accident. Practically unavoidable. Well, yeah. I don't know how I feel about that, but it does seem like it was. Could have been an accident, depending on what her children were up to. They can't exactly be held liable, depending on their age. Oh, this is cool. I like this. Okay. Oh, right click still exits. David, from David Munchie, Neurograph Session. Thank you again for participating in our research. The scan will be performed at Pace Laboratories in Toronto, but since we are guests, our access is a bit unpredictable. I will try to schedule a scan session for Saturday. I'll get back to you when confirmed. Sincerely, David Munchie. That was so. Presumably, that's recently. Cool. New prescription from Aaron Peak. Okay, that was the thing we read. Dear Mr. Jarrett, I'm happy to hear your headaches have become less frequent. Your latest tests show your brain is slowly recovering, but it's still too early to tell how well it will adjust to the damage. The bleeding will continue over the coming months at least, and you will need to come to the hospital a few times to drain the cavity to prevent the blood from building up pressure. Okay. Since excessive stress could be fatal, I have written you a prescription for Prozac to help you with your nightmares. Please read the instructions and medicate accordingly. Try to get a lot of rest, and I will see you next week. Okay, so that's why I need to do things, because blood might kill me. Jesse, the Grimoire, Saturday off.
Forgot to hit send. Does it matter? I already told him about it.
Hi, Jesse, since you probably forgot, here's me reminding you that I've got the doctor's appointment tomorrow, i.e. I'm not coming into work. This means you need to make sure that you're actually on time and to open up the store. Please unpack the boxes behind the counter. They are starting to become a workplace hazard. Also, books tend to sell much better if they are put on shelves or people are able to actually see them. Good luck, you'll need it. So I wonder if this guy, if he's just... So, okay, 1st of May, so it's presumably May 2nd. Oh, I feel special. Yes, it's May 2nd. I'm gonna go ahead and send that, because it seems like he's pretty forgetful, and he might be.
Better late than never.
Yeah. Agreed. Wrong button. Maybe he's supposed to be, like, I don't know, maybe he's mentally retarded or something. Might as well remind him to be productive. Oh, that's beautiful. Or he's just a really bad, really lazy bastard. Has memory problems. Doesn't seem like his tone. Either the guy I'm playing is an asshole, if that is the case, because his tone seems a little bit dismissive. Mapping minds. Wildly praised as one of the most comprehensive yet accessible texts about the human anatomy. The anatomy of the human brain, its function, and our perception of consciousness. Find out how your brain is dependent on its body, why the brain is simply not a computer, and a multitude of interesting facts that will make your head spin. This edition also includes 2 new chapters about the development of the brain and how it affects our behavior at different stages of our lives. Cool. Okay, so he's reading brain stuff because he's, you know, dying of brain things. Oh, hey! The first massive recoil! John Hugh is a corrupt cop working in Hong Kong. One day his life is turned upside down as he meets Amber, a mysterious foreigner who is kept prisoner by the Golden Dragon Triad. Get ready to go rogue. It's time to go against the Triad, the police, and the supernatural forces of the underground. Get ready for massive recoil. This is just... God, for sale outside. I like the copyright notice, even. It's just the most generic sounding... the most generic sounding action movie. So this guy does not have the most agreeable tastes, in my opinion.
Right. Watching TV gives me headaches now. Thank you, brain.
Is that why there's no disc? Doesn't really explain why there's no disc. And fuck it. No. Can't interact with that. That's disappointing. But I guess there will be much more interactivity to be had. Chairs. If you think about what's happening here, this would be really bad. He's just like lifting a chair over his head. Ah, physics. I have missed you. Ooh, constraints. That's cool. So it's just a straw in a cup. I'm messy. I should clean up. It's dark over here. That's better. So I'm still looking for that food. Is there like a journal?
A bit of fast food. Should buy something healthier on my way home.
What was that square? Is that my inventory? Okay, so I'm hitting tab. So I have no functional inventory. Presumably there's also... I shouldn't throw that away. It has pizza in it. I could eat unceremoniously. I mean... Maybe there are other reasons his brain is dying. It doesn't seem to... What is this? I don't know what this is. Dawn. Damn it! Ugh. It's not very scary yet, because I'm just... Okay, pizza. Ah! Not clean! No! I should not have set the FOV that wide, it's a little weird. I'll shrink it for the... Oh! Letter! Okay. Right. Can I? Can't. I want to open you! Open letter! Ugh, whatever. What is this? It looks like the kind of thing that you shouldn't hang shit on. That's all I know. Ooh, clothes! Ooh. Oh, that's great. Fling. I love that. Socks. He just leaves his socks out? Gross. And shoes. Well, I mean, I guess if you're gonna have socks and shoes. Oh, hey, the lean buttons. It's been a while since I've been in the game with lean buttons. Okay. So that does not go into my inventory. We are learning. There is another light. So many little discreet lights.
There it is.
Oh, okay, so I can't complete this after all. Plus left displayed on the screen. So, okay. His arm looks strange. Do I have to hold it? No.
Feels like milk, but the taste, it's like sucking on a penny.
I kind of wasn't paying too much attention as to why that is. Can I? Are those all like individual things or? No, okay. They're not that mad. Three unused drawers. What else is there? Am I making contact with water somewhere? Cool. He's not. Cool. I just like that everything is interactive. It also really bothers me that my sink is making noises. That? That's just water. It's just water. Okay. I must be kicking around the thing that's inside it. No! Come on. Oh, I closed it. Okay. There are plugs everywhere. I have noticed this. That seems excessive.
Hey, Simon. It's Jesse. You working this weekend or what? I knew there was something you were doing. Was it this weekend or next? Anywho, just shoot me a mail or something. Love you, Miss You Mean It.
End of messages.
I swear, that guy has the memory of a goldfish. Well, I got the email off. He must have caught up by now.
Well, that's cool. Yeah, so, I seriously missed the phone conversation because I remember, I think it's just telling me to go find the juice. So that was kind of cool and kind of bad, because I'm pretty sure it doesn't make sense. He made a comment here that made it seem like he had already been called, or that it was too late, and then clearly it wasn't. Then he commented here that, like, oh yeah, it's fine. So alright, well, I have keys, I've taken my weird juice. Off we go to elsewhere. To loading screen. Oh, okay. Other people. I'm kind of glad I put on the caption because I didn't really understand that at all. So my phone? Yeah.
Jesse.
Hey, Simon. I got your email. Just wanted to wish you good luck and let you know I got you covered.
Thanks. I should be able to come to the store after this scan.
Don't sweat it. I got Matt and Chris helping me out.
Matty from SNL?
Guess you didn't hear. He's coming in full time, working the comic section.
That's Ashley's job.
Yeah, well, I know.
Forget it. Not doing her any favors by leaving an empty spot. Not like she's coming back.
Well, good luck. Hope they find a way to reverse the whole... Dying thing?
You're the worst support ever.
We're all dying.
What should I say?
I'll see you later, Jesse. Don't burn the place down while I'm gone.
Over that bike.
Won't find me in a phone booth.
Okay, they're just friends, and he's just a forgetful guy. So the mail wasn't. I wonder how that pans out if you don't send that now. He just calls with like, what the fuck?
Hello? Dr. Munchie?
This looks legit.
Where is everyone? Thought this place would be busy.
I should probably turn down the, I'm gonna go ahead and do that because the frame rate's suffering too much. Stutters too much. Don't need that high shadow quality anyway. And while I'm here, let's push that down. Yeah. I think that'll be a little bit nicer. I usually go for 120, but I don't know, things I guess in this game are a little bit more grounded than usual, so it feels weird. I can't tell if that's not semi-translucent pan. Ah, there we go. Color is balanced again. Hot and cold. Alright, so where is that guy? I'm here to get my brain scanned so I don't die. I like this consistency in the world. Like, this is a chair, therefore you can move it. Like all the other chairs, you know. That's kind of creepy. Maybe it's just a plant, though.
This is the place, right? Must be. Let's just call Munchie real quick.
Can I move?
Great.
Okay.
Got his phone turned off.
I like this kind of interaction.
That's okay. I can figure this out.
Where, I pulled up the phone, it's kind of cutscene-y, right? Because, like, I'm not doing that. But I can still move around. It's kind of like an audio log or something. This is alarming. These are, like, new. What gives? I feel like it moves too slowly, though. Is this what it looks like when you try to paint a clown and have some kind of vision or brain damage? Okay, so there's gonna be weird pictures on the walls. That looks good. That's probably not indicative of anything bad at all. Just need to paint the walls. Yeah. I mean, that looks kinda nice, but their clearly original strength is not open city spaces, because that's functional. But minimal in a lot of ways. I like how this chair is now just stuck. Okay, well, I guess we can turn off the lights now. See, it's this kind of game, it was just going through my head, like, maybe I need to go into the ceiling. Like, that's not what happens in real life. People don't crawl into... What's that noise? Did I just make that noise? Do we have a smoke detector? Alright, well, since I'm dying, I feel justified looking at your laptop. Okay. So he sent a mail out to... Why is this the inbox? Oh, because this is Paul at yourcarney.ca. Okay. Talked to Pace about using the lab this week. I've managed to book the scanner for tomorrow morning and again on Friday. It's not a lot, but they said we could use the empty recreation area as a kind of office. It allows to use the computers to run models. And also, if the time slot opens up, we can get in there and use the scanner rig right away. I thought we could run some tests tomorrow. We could do a scan of each other to learn the equipment. It's supposed to be pretty easy. On Friday, I'm hoping Dr. Aaron Peake will send somebody over. She has a patient that was recently in a car crash. Should be interesting. This still sounds suspicious. We're locked out from... To David Munchie from Paul. Right. I found some extra time in the lab today. Unfortunately, nobody told us about the code change, so I called security and talked to Professor Wei to have him vouch for our project, and finally got a hold of some honcho over at Pace's legal department that could re-grant us permission to use the lab. I'm not allowed to repeat the code and mail text, but leave a note or something in case we forget. Paul. Okay. Scared now. Where are you? I got your laptop in reception. Are you already here? Call me ASAP. Okay, so... I still want to hit escape to get out of things. So is there a note with the code? Hello, computer. You were shiny. I I need to find a code. So, all right. So we found a puzzle already. You threw it away. Right, drawers. No, it's just office supplies. What's this? What kind of object? Oh, it's a pencil bag. It sounds like one, I should know that. Low three sums, blurry, neurographics, Nakajima? Page 66, so this is like some technical thing. Delplin Medford Panicam, I can't read that. 2501, oh wait, there it is, 2501. Yeah, that's probably the code. It did say leave a note, so off the bit, there it is. The trial and error science news. Put the scalpel away. The brain can heal itself. The brain has an amazing transformative quality of plasticity that allows it to compensate and even heal itself, explains Paul Berg, graduate student in neuroscience at York University in Toronto. So that's this guy. Oh, hey! Wuxi and Berg. So, guy on the right is Berg. There's our suspicious guy. Okay. It is this quality that Berg and his colleague David Munchie, a student of computer science, with the CS major, is the guy scanning my... are hoping to encourage. It's about getting the brain to do the right thing, and we hope to accomplish this with simple things like exercise, therapy, and light medication. But Munchie and Berg are not looking for a miraculous panacea. It's about finding the optimal treatment for each patient. We start out recording something called a Nakajima neurograph. It's like a picture that indicates direction. 1. Damaged brain scan to produce a computer model. 2. Numerous tests conducted on model without risk. 3. Perfected treatment is then applied to patient. Okay, I guess, well, as soon as your model's really good. It is not a long forecast, but it's about milliseconds. But with the right computer model, Berg and Munchie can then administer all kinds of treatments without risking the actual harm to the brain. We could try giving your brain an overdose of painkillers while running a marathon, suggests Berg. It's just a computer model, but we are able to fail treating you a million times over only to find the right way. I like that quote, we are able to fail treating you a million times over. And when they do find that optimal treatment, that's when they apply it to the real patient. It's still in the early stages, but the project has caught the attention from Pace Laboratories, who has promised to assist them with both equipment and workspace. We're very fortunate to get all the support, says Berg. Now we just need to get out of the limelight and actually do the work. So that's kind of neat, I guess, the whole flash drive. Okay. I'm gonna do something with this? Jam it in there. Jam it. No. Chair. Chair, you foiled me again. Oh, wait. If he has a laptop, what's this thing up to? Oh, it's that thing. Okay. I was like, wait a minute. Evidence of my crime. 2501, I still remember. I wish there was, there might be. No. No? Oh, that's a missed opportunity. Well, I guess it's a differently structured one. I was trying to hit my numpad, because that was one of the things I loved about the original Deus Ex, and I guess the third one as well, where you could enter key codes like that. Oh! Run with shift. If you've watched my Darkwood videos, I've mentioned how I say about that. I know that they usually try to teach you to run in safe places, but... Monday, James, 9 to 12, okay. I'm just trying to interact with everything for now. National Oceanic Hemispheres. Yeah. They're like, you can run. Here's a safe place for you to run. Don't worry about it. And then I always worry that I'm gonna... That's a real symbol and it means something. I don't know what it is. Is this my room? Steve, all day. Yeah, this is my room. Okay. So where is everyone? I'm gonna get my brain scanned. Like, kind of experimental. This is just like experimental. That's wireless mass. Giant needle. Unrealistic refraction. Well, yeah, it's not so bad. Get over there. Is there a light in here? Oh, yes. Light. Good. Light, very good. Wish I could zoom a little bit. Yeah, okay. Is that a giant... Are these monitors? What is this? What the hell is this thing? Because that's a lot of monitors. Why does my frame rate tank when I look at that area? What's... Don't you that at me. I know what this game's about, kind of. Concerned me. Okay. The nervous system. That's a real picture. Time has stopped. The clock is dead. They're trying to fix something. Should walk on that. Can't do... Something's broken. Oh, hey.
Oh, hi. Didn't hear you come in. Simon Jarrett, right?
Dr. Munchie?
Well, it's just Mr. Munchie, but I'm working on it. Actually, you're helping me right now.
Is this part of your thesis work?
Yeah. It's a study I'm doing with my colleague, Paul Berg. We hope to design a gentle way to work with brain reconstruction to help people like you. Oh, did you, take the tracer fluid?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Great. Well, we can start whenever you're ready.
This is different from amnesia.
So, what exactly are we doing?
We're gonna do a scan of your brain. Then we build a computer model of it and bombard it with stimuli. The program will help us to quickly iterate your treatment plan until it's fully optimized. In short, develop the perfect treatment for your condition.
So it's not just a study, this will actually help me.
I should hope so. Otherwise, this would be a huge waste of time.
Okay. But I'm not supposed to be back here. Why don't you remark on that? The door was locked. Smooth mouse turned on. No, okay. That was on by default. I turned it off because it was...
You know, I have a serious condition, right? You heard about the car crash, the X months to live deal?
Yes, I heard. Must be hard having to hear that. As you know, it's because your brain is weakened so much that it can start to bleed every so often.
And if it ever gets real bad, it will kill me.
Well, we probably can't restore your brain completely, but we should be able to make those X months turn into years, decades even. If you take care of yourself and don't do anything too crazy, we should be able to get you to outlive the best of us.
Uh-huh.
I really hope you're right about this.
Me too. This could make a huge difference for how we treat people with brain damage. So, what do you say? Should we get going?
Sure. Let's get started.
Take a seat.
I can't talk to him anymore. Okay, so that's like a Dark Souls-esque. Talk to people until they stop. Maybe. I guess we'll find out. What could go wrong? Chop, 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 chop. Since they don't have any kind of culling, so when I look over there. I don't like this.
Alright, let me just get this out of the way. You are Simon Jarrett, correct?
Right.
From Canada, Munchie. Born 1988, July 16th.
Right.
Flat neurograph, version 6. Good. All files in order.
Will this hurt?
It's just a scan. It'll hurt about as much as getting your picture taken.
Indians thought cameras would steal their souls.
Is that so? Well, let's hope they're wrong. Ready? Say cheese.
Supposed to happen? I'm guessing it stole my soul.
What happened?
Hello? Mr. Munchie?
Oh, that's cool, yeah. I'm pushing W right now.
Did something go wrong?
Can't see anything. It's really dark. I'm actually able to make out the imperfections.
This isn't funny!
Where's the light switch?
I'm not supposed to put myself in...
Light switch is gone. Light switch.
This is kind of stressing me out.
What? Is this hell? It's just some kind of Bioshock. Oh man. I don't quite understand what just happened. Am I pushing that, or was it just twitching of its own accord? No, I'm pushing it. Those look like entrails, if I've ever seen them. What can I pick up here? This, obviously, but... Okay.
Chinese or Japanese.
Oh boy. Lock terminal from service console, okay. I'll stop touching everything soon, I promise. Probably. What is this? This looks like some kind of diving suit. Okay. Okay, service console. Insert Omni tool to access. Alright, it's serious about it. Well, that looks like a button I want to press. I don't know if I should... Is there an Omni tool in here, or is that what I'm actually supposed to be doing? I hear sounds. Don't like those sounds. But it didn't have blood on it, it's just red over there. Alright, not happy about that. How am I here? Am I even here? Boots. I feel like one of these things has an Omni tool. Omni-tool docking station. Alright, well I need an Omni-tool. And I'm trapped here. So that's my own locking. Say 50 quality placements for something. Do not enter. This. Oh, cool. Door's open. Excellent. Saving, presumably. What?
It's working better than expected. They're having a really hard time getting the doors open.
Call Permaseal as many as you can, rather not take any chances.
Roger. Did you cut off the factory floor?
All done. Should keep most of them out. I'm on my way to lock off the comms tower.
Just make sure to leave a way out of here.
Trust me, I'll get you that data safe.
How did I do that?
Is it coming out of the wall? What is this? It's weird. Is that something? No. It is. I can't track. This is the coffee room. I like how the trash cans have stuff in them. That's a nice detail. Oh. Cool. Home is a state of mind. Sure it is. Just like whatever this place is, presumably. Yellow means closed, but openable. Why could I have this? Can I ever return it to its home? Yes, I can. Bathrooms! Oh, what went wrong here? Fly sounds. There are flies down here. Tech depot. Is that the this is the tech depot, okay. Everything makes mechanical sounds. No storage permitted. This is locked? Yeah. I think I want to open that. Machine hangar. Mind your head. Oh, come on. I have a feeling I'm going to regret this. I don't even know where to hide. Oh. I can get out as soon as possible. Why is everything so noisy? 895 worker. Heimat. That's probably what that says. That's an E right there. What is this? It looks almost like a plant. Only kind of? Oh, it's probably just making some... What? What? Stop flickering light. I saw the screen. I don't like that. Don't like that. What does it mean? There's something in that corner. Oh boy. Oh boy. What? Where did it stop? Well, that's just going crazy. Is it you? I don't understand what to do or what to be afraid of. Or what? Can I hide in here? No. I heard a big noise. Don't like that. Hi. Oh, man. Hi. What? good. Now you're teaching me to lead. What was that? Something just burst through there. Before I go there, I want to make sure I get through all of this.
It's working better than expected. They're having a really hard time getting the doors open.
Call Permaseal as many as you can, rather than take any chances.
Roger. Did you cut off the factory floor?
All done. Should keep most of them out. I'm on my way to lock off the comm center.
Just make sure to leave a way out of here.
Trust me, I'll get you to data safe and sound. We just need to make sure we leave enough power running so we don't have to return.
I hear that. See you back at camp.
Eerie? Oh, first aid. Burns, fractures, bleeding, recovery position. Recovery position? Okay, well. Robot dock, service station, breakroom tech depot, thermal plant seems like a place we're gonna wanna go soon. I hear stuff everywhere. What's going on? I'm so scared. I'm really scared. Okay, that's the thing. It's moving. Heard that. Should I be afraid that I heard that? It's not a thing. I think that means something is nearby. It's over there. Oh boy, I'm not gonna be talking very much. Sound is or where the cups were up. Guess I should check these things out before triggering that. Oh boy. I knew it. You go. Thank you. No? We good now? I don't want to open that door. It sounds like a bad idea. Maybe I don't want to open the door. Maybe I just want to leave it there. There's stuff around here. Right, that's locked. What's that noise? Okay. I like this. It's too noisy. But otherwise, it's okay. Is this why we're out of power? What is this stuff? Looks like it's some kind of organic growth. Can I touch it? Ow!
Shit!
Why? Why do you make this so difficult? Hello. Yeah, you're coming with me. I can't parse what I'm seeing. Presumably. I want to go this way. Swipe Omni tool. I don't have one. How do I get one? Everything's so dark. Probably need to like uncalibrate my monitor. It's calibrated for this lighting condition. This game was made. The assumption that you would be calibrated for normal lighting conditions. So nice. Sound transition work. It's pretty cool. Game. That's drippy stuff. Oh boy. Trust it. Trust nothing. Okay. No! Game, why? You're mean, game. You're really mean, game. Why? I have to be standing in front of it. Okay. I don't think... No. Where is whatever's doing the lean forward? Ah! I didn't mean to do that. No, I can't lean forward. The only game ever to do that was Deus Ex. Shit. Is that a good idea? I don't even know. I don't feel safer. Trust nothing. Alright. Yes? No. I can move everything though if I wanna. Oh. Okay. The Omni tool is an advanced interface for accessing, managing, and controlling computerized systems. The onboard intelligence includes an open set of behaviors and protocols to enable the user to automate routine actions through basic logical trends. Over time, the Omni tool will automatically adapt its program to cover subconscious behavior to optimize work and minimize error. The Omni tool has a short-range signal useful for basic automated actions such as opening doors. But for complex operations, with the Omni tool should be physically connected to a workstation or terminal. Let's upgrade your device, and we slide operators into the main RV auxiliary slot. The main slot has a standard C11-21 connector, which allows the user to fit most market Cortex chips into the Omni. Note that introducing an additional AI will override the onboard intelligence. The auxiliary slot is a multi-connector fitting a large range of toolchip models, including but not limited to, and I'm not going to read those out because I don't know, juicy, height. I don't know if those are useful. We'll find out. Alright, so I guess this is where we obtain our Omni tool and get stabbed. Why are you dripping so much? Stop kicking stuff, making noise. It's a bad idea. Omni tool. Just too many noises. Go away. They don't close. Of course they don't. I don't want to pick that up. Bad things will happen when I pick that up. I'm going to try. That has no impact. What's that? What was that noise? These look like spinal cords, rib cages, growing. This is material. Stop making sound everywhere. I don't want this. I do not want this. AI Helper J. So I now have an inventory, but I don't know what it means. Alright. How did whatever was in here get out? Worries me deeply. Okay. Stop with the noises. So I now have an Omni tool, which means that I can go back to the beginning. Hello! Please don't. The purple. Purple seems new. I don't remember purple. I don't know what to expect. Sneak around. Music? No, why? Were you there before? I think you were. Some would be a chase sequence. I don't want to run right now. I'm not equipped for that. Why does everything make noises? Okay. Uh oh. Where is it? I saw it. I saw its glow. It's where I need to go. Of course it is. I'm going to crawl. Oh boy. Crawl in here. Wait! Why is there so much noise? This is the wrong time to crack that one. Hello? This is empty. It's good. Don't want to go there. Don't want to go there. It's scary. There were creepy lights. It's probably over there. I'm gonna have to close the light, the door. Stop it, Gabe. Stop it. Oh, right, of course. So loud. Hi. Oh no. I'm touching you. Oh boy. I don't like this. Okay, off we go. Pathos 2, huh? Chip installer.
Service console optional 3, including pilot seat activated.
Remote access denied, servers offline, main power suspended. Program unreliable denied. 13 days of emergency systems remaining. Okay. Upsilon, theta cache, unfold. Subject Simon Jarrett. Terminal scan. Alright, this sounds like the information he was putting in. Operation unavailable. Complete. David Lynchy, 2015, V1. Anomaly tool. Managed tool chip. Welcome back, Louise Muron. Anomaly tool's in perfect condition, but not fatal with a tool chip. Not inserted. Not a tool kit. FST kit will be unavailable, including a cross-site security access. To continue using your designated privileges, please insert a tool chip and run an update. So I don't have a tool chip. Okay. Nor a Cortex chip. Currently being served by default onboard intelligence helper Jane. Note that installing a Cortex chip will override the helper and may severely alter your user experience. Okay. Lock toolbox. Orientation.
I know they told you that field technicians would get full access throughout Pathos 2. I'm here to tell you that's not gonna happen. Don't get me wrong. I don't want to get in your way. We need you guys to keep this place up and running. But there needs to be at least some level of security on these things. I don't want to hear you barge into some quarantined area at Omicron and just knock down the whole place with some virus or whatever the hell they're doing over there. This is what you can do. You'll be able to use it to open doors, basically all of them. If you can't, there's something wrong or someone didn't want you in there. Then what do? You shove that Omnitool into a terminal and see if you can't get around it somehow. I mean, sometimes you'll need to get into places where you don't belong. Just find a way. You're an engineer, for crying out loud. What else? Take care of your gear. Don't be an asshole. That's about it, really. My name is John Strohmeyer, Pathos 2 security operative. I got an office at Theta. Come see me if you got any issues you can't handle yourself. Good luck.
Theta, huh? Unlock toolbox. Inventory. Basic ductile suits 1, 2, 6. 3 has some unknown contamination, 5 and 6 are in use, all the rest are just here. All Haimatsu power suits stored at Omicron. Okay. Very carefully looking at that thing. So I can't. Oh! Things! Are they all the same? Yes. I guess. Does it matter where I put. Oh, there we go.
Tool chip found.
old ship. Alright. So I have a tool chip now. Manage tool chip. Update. Height 7. Wasn't that one of the ones we're not supposed to be able to install?
Tool chip security cipher. Updated.
Oh, okay. So now I can get to more places, presumably. Level 3 access. Probably not a coincidence. Looks exactly like the kind of chair that I sat down in. Pilot seat. It's a pilot seat. Reports. Pilot report. Number doesn't matter. Pilot Carl Semkin, supporting Yatsaro Vehicle Tugger UH-3. Replace heat shields on the southern flue, result of success. Now, Semkin reported uncharacteristic levels of nausea after the mission. Diagnostics show a spike of electromagnetism surrounding the pilot helmet, which is believed to be the cause of Semkin's symptoms. No indication to what created this anomaly. Excellent! Sounds like a VR motion sickness, but with magnets, or whatever. Attention, the pilot system has become increasingly unreliable. Everyone who's been using it the last couple of months has been having headaches and spells of nausea. Last week, Gavin was knocked out for 30 hours while trying to direct a helper cluster. This is not acceptable. We will figure this out, but for the time being, I'm shutting down the user pilot system. This means you have to do some more heavy lifting, performing the operations through programming or physical labor. No one's happy about this, so don't bother campaigning. Jane Addams, Chief Factor. Okay. Now, just pilot seat number 3, Upsilon. In progress. What? There's no one here. Okay. It's just random hex strings. I'm sure if I was enterprising enough, I could, like, type it in and get some lore out of tossing out various decodes. Construct network? Yeah, okay. Pilot status. No pilot. Right. Engine status. Right, it's all offline. Why does in prog... I guess it's just showing garbage. Okay. Well, that's that. I now have a better Omni tool. That was actually just me.
Wow.
Okay, well, I have a better Omni tool now. And, yeah. Pretty sure that there's something right over there waiting for us. But, I think that this video has probably gone on quite long, so I'm going to stop here for now. We'll get to start with all the action next time. Hopefully it's saved recently, because these games... Oh, I guess we'll save an exit. So, with that, join me next time for some more SOMA. I hope you've enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.